Today, we will take a look at how Azure Site Recovery can help you to keep your applications available in the event of a disaster. I'll show you how you can set up replication for your on-premises applications to Azure, and how you can test the solution works in the event of a disaster to meet your compliance needs. If you are new to Azure Site Recovery, it is a service that allows you to replicate your applications and fail over to Azure so that you can plan for and enable business continuity. Let me show you how you can go about setting up your on-premises data center with disaster recovery in Azure. Here I have a VMware ESX farm running in my data center. I have Linux virtual machines running Apache and MySQL. There are a few steps you'll have to take to connect your on-premises environment to Azure and to replicate your applications, which I'll show you in another tenant. The first thing you will need to do in Azure is create a recovery services vault. This holds your settings, monitoring and reports, policies, protected items, the management plane for the resources that you are managing, as well as your site recovery plan. Here, I have a number of vaults created. To create a new one, I click Add, and there are a number of steps that I need to complete in order to finish creating my recovery services vault. In my case, I've already created one, but once you've created your recovery services vault, there are three main steps to set up Azure Site Recovery. Preparing your local infrastructure, replicate your applications, and preparing your recovery plan. Let's get started with preparing your local infrastructure. To do this, I'm going to click my recovery services vault that I want to set up site recovery for. Under Getting Started, I'm going to select Site Recovery. Next, Prepare Infrastructure. I will set my protection goal of replicating applications on-premises to Azure on VMware virtual machines and click OK. To orchestrate the connectivity between our on-premises environment, I'm going to add vCenter. I'm going to enter my host-friendly name, the host account from the drop-down menu, and click OK. Next, I'm going to select Replicate Applications and select my source for configuration, which will be on-premises. I will complete a couple steps, ending with selecting my process server and clicking OK. Next, I'll select the configuration target for where I want my applications to run in Azure. I'll select virtual machines, configuration properties, and replication settings. And my last step is to manage my recovery plan. This is where you can customize your recovery plan and test for failover without impacting production workloads or end users. To customize, this means that I can sequence the failover of multi-tier applications running on multiple VMs. To get more detail on all of these steps, you can check out the link below. Now, let me show you the experience once you've passed the setup stage in my original environment that I've already set up. You can see here that Azure is now directly connected to my vCenter instance on-premises. If I look at the replicated items, you can see that the five Linux virtual machines that I showed you earlier are now set up. Now I'm going to go to my recovery plan, and I'm going to select Customize. This is where you can determine what needs to happen and in what order for failover to work. In this case, I've customized my recovery plan so that MySQL database needs to be running before group 2, which is the app tier, which needs to come up before group 3, which is the web tier. When I go to group 4, you can see that I have a public-facing internet IP. This enables me to turn on virtual machines in a specific order and then run scripts. Because I have set up my recovery plan, I can do a single-click failover, and it will execute these items. To give you peace of mind, we allow you to test that your recovery plan will work in the event of a disaster and meet your compliance needs without impacting your production environment or end users. So let's go ahead and simulate an outage. There could be many reasons for an outage, ranging from a natural disaster to human error. In this case, let's assume an outage is due to human error by shutting down our VMware ESX VMs. To do this, I'm going to hit power, shut down, and it's going to ask me if I really want to shut this down. And I'm going to click OK. This will bring down services reliant upon those VMs within our public website. So if I hit refresh, we'll see that the site is down. Now to test failover, I'll go back to the Azure portal and I'll choose failover. And I'm going to select my latest application consistent recovery point. That's the last state of our services and applications, and choose OK. This is going to kick off the recovery services process. You can see here that the recovery is moving forward. And because our recovery process is sophisticated, it will take a few minutes to spin. Once it's complete, you'll be able to see that your applications are running. And when we refresh our website is back and running. We've successfully recovered from the outage. Getting started with Azure Site Recovery is easy. It's built into Azure, so as long as you have an Azure subscription, you can get started today, and it's free to use for the first 31 days. Also, the Azure Hybrid Use Benefit allows you to apply existing Windows Server licenses towards this effort. You can learn more about this benefit on our recent demo bench. And for detailed documentation on how to get started with Azure Site Recovery, you can visit the link below. Thanks for watching.